In September 2019, the Praxis Core Math has been updated from 5732 to 5733. But besides those numbers, what are the differences and which one should you take? In this video, we're going to answer those questions. I'm Anderson, the Math Director of Learning Liaisons. Let's go ahead and get started. So first off, the test changed in September 2019, and you can take the old version still until August 2020. At that point, then the old one, 5732, will be obsolete, and you will only be able to take the new version. And again, that's August 2020. You can find the blueprint for either test on the ETS website with links located in the description of this video. But plain and simple, the changes were made to more accurately reflect the skills that all educators should possess. So from the ETS website, the process of re-examination was designed to ensure that all the skills CORE is measuring are confirmed as critical. Skills are important for success regardless of which path a candidate takes through the program and regardless of which grades or subjects the candidate will teach. And so what this means is that there's more of an emphasis on critical thinking and conceptual fluency and not procedural fluency. So a quick lesson here, the difference between conceptual and procedural fluency is that with conceptual fluency, you can discuss what you're talking about. You can discuss the math and you know how it works at its core. Now with procedural fluency, that's more so memorization. So knowing certain formulas, knowing certain processes, and just being able to regurgitate them. They want to get away from that, and that's why they made these changes. This means that they did away with some types of problems, but for the most part, the content is the same. And so to make sure that we're all knowledgeable, everything that stayed the same, the test is still 90 minutes, still 56 questions, and again, that gives you just about a minute 35 seconds per question. There is still an on-screen calculator, and the types of questions have not changed. You still have multiple choice option questions where you have selected response for one option, and then you have selected response for multiple options, or those that say select all that apply. You also still have numeric entry questions, and the four categories are pretty much the same. One of them, their name was changed just a little bit, but again, it's still the same exact thing. So those four categories, those main ones, are number and quantity, data interpretation, and this was changed from statistics and probability from the old version to data interpretation and representation, statistics and probability in the new one. I know that's a mouthful, but again, it's still the same exact type of content with some minor changes. And then we still have algebra and geometry. So the passing score for most states, it's still 150. Some states like Mississippi, theirs is 130. And you can find the link to find out what your state's passing score is in the description of this video. So let's move on and talk about what's been removed. Again, they made these changes so that they can have all the problems on this test to be identified as critical for educators to possess, which means that they took away the problems that they identified as non-critical for educators to possess. And those types of questions include identifying rational versus irrational numbers, solving problems with radicals, working with functions, and solving problems including three-dimensional figures like volume and surface area of a cone and other types of cone figures, prisms, pyramids, things like that. In addition, they're going to go ahead and provide you with the geometric formulas that you're going to need for a lot of these problems. Again, the purpose of the change is to do away with procedural fluency, with just memorizing how to do certain types of problems. They want you to think more critically about the problems that you're doing, which is why they're going to be providing you with the memorized formulas in those geometric problems. That way, you can go ahead and worry less about memorizing and more about thinking and engaging with the problem itself. All right, so let's go ahead and get into the structural changes of the test. This is the juicy part, so go ahead, pay attention real close here. So again, those four categories are still there. Their order has been shifted from number and quantity, data interpretation, algebra, and geometry. Those four are still there, but the weight of each or the amount of questions therein has changed. So before, algebra was rated 30%. It was 30% of your test, and geometry was 20%. After the changes, they decided to make sure that there's less of an emphasis on algebra and geometry, where a lot of those procedural problems are, where you just memorize a process. And afterward now, algebra went from 30% to 20% of your test. Geometry went from 20% to 12%, which is huge for a lot of our folks out there who really don't like algebra and geometry. But with those cuts in algebra and geometry come an increased emphasis on data interpretation. Again, the test remained the same in terms of the amount of questions. So by doing away with some algebra and geometry, we need more data interpretation and number and quantity. So the percentages went up as follows. They went from 20% in statistics and probability to 32% in that really long category, data interpretation and representation, statistics and probability. So let's go ahead and talk about numbers though, because percentages don't quite do us justice, right? So in the old version, you could have expected to see 17 algebra problems and 11 geometry problems, totaling 28 algebra and geometry problems. Now, you can go ahead and expect a total of 18 in both total combined, which means you'll have 11 algebra and 7 geometry. It's not evenly split down the middle. They did put more of an emphasis on algebra than geometry. So again, you now only have to worry about 18 total questions for algebra and geometry combined, formerly 28, which is a good help for some of us here. But for the first two categories, number and quantity and data interpretation, number and quantity went from 17 questions to 20 questions now. So there's going to be three more questions involving number and quantity. And now with data interpretation, that has been increased from 11 questions to 18. So again, a huge emphasis on data interpretation, a huge, huge emphasis there. And so essentially to recap, just about a third of your test will be number and quantity. About a third of it will be data interpretation, and a third of it will be algebra and geometry combined. So again, for those of us that don't like algebra and geometry, it's your lucky day or lucky year, however you want to think about it. But at the same time, we really want to consider which version we should actually take, because we do have until August 2020 until the old version is obsolete and only the new version will be accepted in most states. So let's go ahead and talk about which one you should take. Look, both tests are going to present their own challenges. In the old version, the 5732, you can expect, again, a lot of it being algebra and geometry, a few of those problems being number and quantity and data interpretation. But no matter what, you're still going to have quite a bit of word problems. You're going to have more word problems in the new version. So if you're not a fan of word problems at all, then maybe stick to the old one. But if you like reading word problems and you can follow a sequence of events logically to be able to basically formulate your own solution process, then the new version is for you. So if you're into procedural fluency, so memorizing how to do certain algebra and geometry problems, memorizing area, memorizing volume, memorizing a lot of these things, then again, old version is for you. The new version emphasizes critical thinking, data interpretation and representation, and number and quantity more so than it does algebra and geometry. So it's really going to be up to you to decide which poison do you want to pick. So again, the old version, less word problems, more algebra and geometry. New version, we have more word problems, less algebra geometry. So it's really going to be up to you. And before we let you go here, we really need to talk about what resources are the right ones to use. So the great thing is here at the Learning Liaisons, we've created a free practice test for the Praxis Core 5733, the new version that you can take today that has video solutions and an answer key that identifies every single skill that each problem is from. That way, you can clear up the confusion and move forward and look at the skills that you need to work on. And that way you can make a plan and tackle it, plain and simple. So go ahead, check out that free practice test for 5733 in the link in the description below. Also, you can check out all of our resources for the 5732 while we create more for 5733. That way you can again pass on your next attempt. It's all about clearing up the confusion. So go ahead in the description of the video below or in the little icon up there, check out the Learning Liaisons website. That way you can put yourself in the best position to pass on your next attempt. And regardless of which test you decide to take, the 3-2 or the 3-3, you need to understand that it's not going to happen by accident. So go ahead, make a plan, and follow through on it. That way, it's not luck, but actual skill that gets you through and passing on your next attempt. We're the Learning Liaisons, and as always, it's when you pass, not if you pass. Check out all the links in the description below. That way, you can stay knowledgeable on everything Praxis Core. That way, you can, again, succeed and pass on your next attempt. We'll see you in the next video.